that is neither here nor there. True North Views Podcast, episode 103. We're almost at 106 in Park. Jeez. I'm joking. Toronto's official, unofficial podcast discussing hip-hop, R&B, and the culture. As usual, I go by the name of Harris.
Y'all know me. Skirtmaster, Mr. Triple Double himself, no assist, stealing 70 mil from the TTC. Jeez! On my way to an NBA championship, you can call me Just Shola. And as usual, we are giving you our reviews from the perspectives of a couple of first generation Canadians.
That Jesus is it's 2A1, man. It's 2A1. Of course, just tell the people where to find us. You can follow us on Instagram, on Twitter, at True North Views. What you will find on our Instagram, of course, is sound bites from our respective episodes for the week. Different topics, different themed topics at that. Album reviews being one of them. Yep. We had a couple of posts that really hit. This past week with a few Griselda topics. So Griselda. Obviously the people want to talk about Griselda. So we really appreciate all the participation. You know, remember that? Remember that campaign, participation?
No.
Participation and action and like jump over hard or some shit. I don't know.
It sounds familiar, but I don't remember. It sounds familiar though. Like you're not saying rubbish.
Yeah. Some
I just
shit,
don't remember
know, some shit. But yeah, man, no, we appreciate, of course, the participation on that. Keep that going. I think one of them had like 200 likes or something like that. So we definitely appreciate that. On our Twitter, what you will find is just random tweeting, random liking, random retweeting.
Retweeting.
Yo, that might be the name of the episode. Retweeting. Yo, jeez. I like when the episode name just comes to me, you know?
Roll off your tongue.
Retweeting. Damn. That's the name of the episode right there. Retweeting. Yeah, man, random tweets, random retweets, random likes, hashtags of the day, topic of the day, whatever it may be. We may be participating in polls as well. And I will talk about BKC a little bit later on, but that's definitely going to be part of the strength and part of the brand going forward. But just know that at this point, we're under quarantine. We're on episode 103. Ain't shit else to do at this point. Point, it's 103% likelihood that if you see a tweeting spree from the at True North Views Twitter account, it happened while I was
back home smoking legal.
Meditation, you see, teaches you two very important things. And shout out to Janae Aiko. Shout out to SZA as well.
What they do?
They're doing them look like salt, like where they put the damn brass looking thing and it makes a sound and it just fucking calms you down with the frequency shit. I'm saying that Lizzo's playing on the... but anyways, man, meditation teaches you two things, awareness and acceptance.
Yes.
If you can get those two things. And shout out to a Toronto Twitter member for adding another one to that. She said acceptance, accountability, and awareness are the three keys to life. And I'm like, listen, man, I've been saying two of them for the longest time, so... I'm gonna add that accountability one in there, not in the intro, but in my head.
In your head.
In my head, like, you see, because meditation teaches you two important things, the two keys to life, awareness and acceptance. And if you can practice those two things while listening to SZA, while watching Janae Aiko live, then you will get these Twitter fingers off as well. Of course, let's start the show in typical quarantine fashion at this point, pre-potpourri. Let's do a corona check. What's new on your mind? How has your mind, your body, your soul changed, adapted, reinvented itself? What are you up to?
Same old, you know.
Same old shit.
Working and watching. Just different day. Well, watching TV. I got my hands on, as you know, the 8 episodes of the Jordan doc.
You did? Yes. I'm not going to say whether allegedly, reportedly, downloaded it.
I got my hands on it. That's all I'm saying. I didn't do it. I don't know what I did with it after.
You're right. I don't know what happened either. I don't even know what you're talking about.
But let's just say I did watch a documentary about basketball.
Okay. So you did watch it, obviously. Yes.
It's actually pretty good. You haven't watched
it? I'll find out on Sunday and the Sunday after that. And the Sunday after that. And
6 months just to watch it.
Listen, man. Ain't shit else to do.
Hey, you know what? You're right.
Ain't shit. And now you got to wait 4 weeks to watch two new content.
Yeah, but at least I know I don't have to worry about this for the next 2 weeks. It's true. That's my thing.
It was
Because even I was even going to watch. I'm going to wait till like I think 6 episodes aired before I actually tried watching it.
Okay, arbitrary.
And I was going to watch 6 episodes up until
whenever. I get it. I'm not mad at that.
Other than that, man, there ain't shit all to do.
Did you start your guitar?
No, I'm not yet. That's still a work in progress.
Your guitar list?
No, not yet. Yo, what's new with you in quarantine?
I did start my piano lessons.
Yeah. You said that. You started with the basics. Do.
I Googled. Do. I YouTubed. I went on YouTube, and I put beginner piano lesson 1.
That always happens. Yeah.
So I see a 30-minute video. I'm like, that's too much. I see a 10-minute video. I'm like, perfect.
That's more like my time.
This guy starts the video. Okay, great. We're just going to teach you a few things just to get used to it. So that's a C note, right? Okay, so a C note. And you have C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. I'm like, okay, I get it.
Yeah, keep it
going. And then, you know, beside C is D. Beside D is E, F, G. And then after G, it resets to A. Right? Or if you want to kind of think about it the other way around, you have your C, and then you go B, A, and then G, you know, whatever, so on and so forth. Okay, I'm following along. You're 2 minutes in.
Like, yo, I'm nice. I'm about to
And I'm like, yo, this. Hold on, let me press pause. Okay, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, D1, D2, D3, D4. I'm like, yo, fam, let's go, we're here. 30 seconds later, he's like, okay, so we're going to learn a couple of basic notes that people play. So we're going to start with the C major, the C minor, the F sharp, and the G flat. And each one contains like 8 different buttons. And I'm like, and he's just like, yeah, like, and he's like, yeah, like almost every song on the planet is only these notes. I'm like, okay.
I just want to see one and see two.
But I'm not going to lie, for as fast paced as it was, I'm almost thankful in hindsight that I watched that because, motherfucker, that crash course, like I sent it to you guys, right? Like you guys kind of saw what I was doing. Fam. That was crazy. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what the fuck? So obviously, you know, the algorithms listen to you, right? So as I'm watching YouTube now, I often see piano advertisements.
Everywhere you go.
So I downloaded one of those apps. I figured, let's see where it goes. How is it?
They're paying,
is it a true pay-to-play? And I mean, let's be real. I wouldn't mind paying for a good layup.
Exactly.
If it's housed in one app.
There you go.
And it's $5.
If it works for you. And you can learn off it.
Even if it's $15, like, why what's not? That really, you know,
the skill you're
learning, the trade-off for, exactly. for a new skill, right? So, I mean, you know, I started that. And again, like I said, with that one lesson, I feel like I learned a lot. Like, almost like I did with the fucking the Instagram school shit, man. You know, Instagram the way school. I be making the Griselda post hit, I went to Instagram school for one class.
Instagram school,
and I learned everything I need to know. So, I'm really proud of myself for doing that, man. But... you know, otherwise, like that just kind of speaks to almost just the general tone of just what's going on in my mind right now, right? Like I talked last week about kind of being uninspired in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. And, you know, again, awareness, acceptance. You got to kind of just let yourself go through that shit.
Exactly.
So, I mean, you know what? Let me, it was right around the time, obviously, the Jordan doc was coming on, right? And, you know, you kind of, you get yourself in Mamba mentality prepared, to watch the Jordan doc, you know what I'm saying? So once I put myself in Mamba mentality to watch Jordan doc, I had no excuses. I'm like, no, I'm coming in this week hot.
I feel you.
I did it. I started my piano lessons. I've, you know, my space is what I want it to be now. I'm reading every day. I'm definitely meditating first thing in the mornings right now. Cause that's whenever I start to fall off is whenever I start to stray away from first thing in the morning. You know, just keeping the mind sharp. Okay, like I said, you know, keep treating my home as a factory in some ways. Like I said, ain't shit else to do nowadays. So, you know, after I...
back home smoking legal.
Then I'll look at, okay, what should I do next? Should I learn the piano? Okay, let me do that for a little bit then.
Back home smoking legal.
Should I learn how to make butter? You know, trim, you know, take care of my plants.
Yes.
You know, things of that nature. And then I...
back home smoking legal.
And then I'm like, should I do a deep dive on an album and just appreciate the music? So I'm just like...
you're everywhere.
There ain't shit else to do. So I'm just like, my life is The Sims right now.
Yo, it is.
My life is The Sims.
I'm not pressing a button up
there. And I'm pressing, because I meditate and I have all this awareness and acceptance, see how life comes at you full circle. I can see it. I can like, and you know, like put myself in a, you know what I'm saying? Like what do I say? Check our YouTube if you want to see what I just did. Yeah, the numbers are going up.
Hey, check our YouTube, man.
The numbers are going up, man.
Check our YouTube.
No, like I said though, man, just trying to keep everything as sharp as possible. The weather is finally getting beautiful.
Warmer.
You know, prior to recording today, I spent all day outside.
You're saying that?
We're looking at a good week of weather. So
jeez, why not enjoy it, man?
I'm gonna be outside all month.
We just had
day.
Winter and this Rona shit.
So yep.
We gotta eat it while we can.
Out in my backyard, of course, you know, because be responsible.
Nah, he's in the park touching everything.
Jeez. Let's get started though, man.
Let's start, please.
Music potpourri. We have a lot of shit to go through.
We got a lot.
And we are already at minute number 10. This is going to be very interesting. So Music Potpourri, of course, is that main segment of the show, hip-hop, R&B, and the culture.
Yep.
We get into kind of some of the general topics from there. We get into our Keep It or Leak It section, then get into our shout-outs. We then talk about what new music has come out for the week, go a little bit more in-depth into the albums that we actually listened to, or singles. From there, we let you know what, in general, is in our rotation. And of course, that could be new music. That could be music that came out just a couple weeks ago. Maybe that got missed, and I'll touch on that later on. Maybe it is old school music. Maybe it's playlist music, especially with all the DJ battles and the DJs playing music that is going on Instagram Live nowadays. So let's get into the show. And of course, we are going to start a little bit on a somber note here. We definitely want to say rest in peace to Fred the Godson, rapper out of New York. You know, not someone that I necessarily followed his music per se, but
I did know of him.
Exactly. Like many artists that I highly respect in their craft, he's one of those names that when you heard the name, you knew what's up.
Yeah.
Right. And even for example, listening to the Joe Budden podcast today, you know, they played a couple of Fred the Godson records in their sleepers. And I'm like, yeah, like this is right up my alley. This is what I like. Mm-hmm. Right. Just again, there's so much music out. You don't get to everything.
You can't.
But, you know, rest in peace. Regardless, you know, he had a family. He had two children, wife.
Unexpected death.
Very unexpected. And you know, shit is real, man. Shit is real with this COVID shit, man. That definitely aided in making these complications worse for him. So you just say prayers up. And you say prayers up to his loved ones, prayers up to a fan of his, prayers up to the hip-hop community as a whole.
Anyone that's life affected.
Anyone that his life has impacted, prayers up to you. And let's kind of, in our usual True North Views fashion, let's play this to kind of shake it off.
Celebrate good times, come on. Let's celebrate.
Part of my week as well, obviously, you already saw it. I got my new laptop.
Hey, okay, new laptop in the building.
Listen, all I'm saying is this. You've seen the True North Views podcast and the major production that it is, right? How it's on YouTube, high def,
HD,
IG looking
HD,
fucking magnifique.
Crystal clear.
You
can look at the formula on that page.
All of that was done on a 2012
jeez.
11-inch
jeez.
MacBook Air, 4 gigabytes of RAM, 64 gigabyte hard drive. All of that was done on that little small-ass machine. So imagine when I upgrade to a MacBook Pro.
About to run it up.
Shit's about to get real over here, man. Anyways, moving on here in our Music Potpourri segment. Let's talk about French versus, I guess French versus Thug would be the headline because they were going back and forth with one another. But this obviously stemmed from the quote-unquote headline saying French versus Kendrick.
Yes.
And obviously the headline is going to misquote things. And I didn't drink my water there. But it's going to misquote things and it's going to, you know, make things more than what they are.
Which is what the headline actually did.
Yes. So do you know the original story?
I know the original story.
Please explain it as a
Do you know the original story?
Not fully. I read the headline.
So he was on, he was getting interviewed, French Montana that is, he was getting interviewed by Complex. And I think he was just talking about his recent battle with Tory Lanez.
Right.
And he didn't say he has more hits. Okay, he did say I have more hits, but he said it more in the tone of if we're putting on a show, which is still wrong,
Yes, and right.
People will want to see me more than Kendrick. And he did also say, like, don't get me wrong, he did not say Kendrick was shit. He even said, he said Kendrick has albums. He said Kendrick has masterpiece albums. I have hit songs.
But nothing, that's what he said. But nothing, like, we have to get out of this mentality. Like, even with the way you're defending, and this is nothing on you, even the way you're kind of defending it as you're explaining it, we have to get out of the mentality. If a rapper is bigging himself up, it doesn't mean he's shitting on someone.
Because everywhere I heard it was that way until I actually heard the interview myself.
Like, it really has to go.
He shit on Kendrick.
It really should go without saying that French was not shitting on
Kendrick. He was not shitting on Kendrick.
Right. So, I mean, kind of like you said, French did say he has more hits. Or I guess in this versus setting, he faced Tory Lanez already. Mm-hmm. He feels like he would win a versus battle, essentially, versus Kendrick.
Correct me if I'm wrong. No, he didn't even say a versus battle. He kind of just said, I have more songs like that are hits than Kendrick. That's kind of like what he was just
saying. Right. No, but I mean, obviously, okay, so people reacted, right? Yes. People reacted, you know, Twitter be tweeting, I always say.
Yeah, Twitter
right?
be tweeting. Yeah, they were tweeting.
Or Twitter be Twittering, tweeters be tweeting, whatever.
We tweeted.
So French went on Instagram and he's like, yo, since this is like an amnesia game, here's my first 20 joints before I dig through my other 21 mixtapes. That's a bar. And he listed 20 songs. You know, Shot Caller, you know, Don't Panic, Pop That, mm-hmm. Lockjaw, Schmurda Remix, Ocho Cinco, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah.
Right? So obviously, within the confines of what we've been dealing with on IG Live,
mm-hmm.
you would have to put it in that arena. So he is basically saying, fam, you're forgetting about me. Yeah, I would beat Kendrick in a 20-song battle. That's essentially what he's saying.
Yeah.
Right?
Does he have a point?
No.
I don't know.
What do you play against Money Trees?
So my problem...
What do you play against Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe?
Here's the thing, and this is an argument I'm only giving. This is the only reason why I think French has a shot.
He doesn't.
Because...
That's the thing.
At the end of the day, Kendrick's songs, even though they're hits, they're not bangers.
Can I ask you something?
Let me just finish.
Okay.
French Montana, and this is let me finish. There's a reason why Kendrick's songs are not bangers and French are bangers.
You got it.
French makes songs for bangers.
Right.
Kendrick does it. Kendrick's songs just happen to be good because he's a good artist. But bangers, if I'm going to a club, you're playing more for bangers. You're playing French more than Kendrick.
What's more of a banger to you, a club record or a festival record?
A club record. That's a banger because that's a bang. Like in a club setting, I'm trying to bang. I'm not trying to think. I'm not trying to do nothing but be in this club and fucking listen to music.
I disagree with that. I think a festival record is more of a banger because, like, we're talking like. DMX performing in front of the whole world versus Fivial Foreign's verse coming on a Drake feature.
But that's a banger.
So you're saying, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's levels to this.
There is.
The club banger is not the festival banger.
But the club
banger I guess the second part of where I was leading with that was, have you been to a Kendrick show?
No, I don't think so.
And I have.
But again, but you're in a Kendrick show. You're not
right.
Everyone there is for Kendrick. So but, everyone there is going to love Kendrick.
But it's not about love or hate. What it's about is I'm at a Kendrick show and he's playing records. And this record in this environment with this sound in this setting in this vibe sounds like the craziest banger I've ever heard in my life.
Because that setting is made for that record.
So, but like, yes and no.
Yes, like, okay, it is. Yes and no. That concert is a Kendrick concert. It's all, okay, everyone it's almost there like, is here to listen to Kendrick music. We are in the mood to enjoy Kendrick. I'm not arguing with
you. No, I know. But we're debating.
We're in the mood to enjoy Kendrick's music.
Okay, but I think that only goes as far as home court advantage.
Yeah.
But the Golden State Warriors in 20, whatever the fuck it was, 16.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the one LeBron won, no?
2016 was the one LeBron won, yeah.
Let's talk about the season then. Let's talk about the season.
2017?
Because the season. Forget playoffs. Because they lost LeBron.
Yeah.
That's when they went 73-9.
Yes.
Right? Weren't they like 40-1 at home?
Something like that.
Okay. So, yeah, you're a better home team than you are a road team. Yeah, a Kendrick record at a Kendrick
show
will
pop off
with Kendrick fans, or he's gonna pop off a little bit more.
Yeah,
but you're still 32-8 away from Oracle. That's still, you still, you're still a banger.
That's what I'm saying. When you go to a festival, like, and Kendrick comes out, like he said, Kendrick's performing an album. That's a masterpiece.
All I'm saying is, bro, what do you play against Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe? Please answer the question.
His hits.
What song goes against
Unforgettable. Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe? Unforgettable.
You're nuts.
Unforgettable?
Give me, okay, what song goes against, like I said, Money Trees?
Again,
these let me pull not, out Damn. Which one goes against
are,
DNA?
I'm not arguing that these give songs me any are bad.
Shot Caller against DNA?
I'm arguing that these Fam, songs are different about? Songs. That's all I'm arguing, that these songs are different songs. And that's the reason why I'm giving French a little bit of,
oh, man.
Of a benefit of the doubt
here. The listeners apparently like when we banter back and forth. Right. I'm just giving the listeners what they want.
Hey, man. I'm just trying to prove my point.
There is no point to prove. I guess that's where I'm going with that. That's nuts. Nice. French would get like four rounds max.
I think this
and it would be like French's mega hits and Kendrick will like
that's what I'm not trying to compare
throw away
them.
A Zakari feature to just to them. Lose the round.
I'm saying if I'm going
those
for
Zakari
hits,
tracks are hard. I'm tripping.
They are. If I'm going for hits, just straight bangers, nodding my head, Kendrick. Jumping up and down. Kendrick's not
I got loyalty, got royalty.
Look at it. See, it just trust me, those songs are good.
Yo,
they're not
tripping.
Hits though. Like they're not like they're nuts. Hits. They're just not
you're
like they're nuts. Not club bangers. That's what I mean. Kendrick is not club bangers. French Montana okay. is club bangers.
Question.
That's what, if it comes to club bangers, I'm giving to French over. That's what I'm saying. Club bangers.
Okay, you
that's
know what?
All I'm saying.
I want to stop bangers. You there because that conversation is going to continue very soon.
All right.
Quick sidebar. 20 for 20. No ESPN.
30
French
30.
Montana versus Soulja Boy.
Oh, French. You think Soulja Boy has 20 hits? I could probably name you 8 Soulja Boy hits, and that's about it. Soulja Boy?
What's French playing against Kiss Me Through the Phone?
Unforgettable. His biggest hit ever. Unforgettable.
Anyways,
against anything. Unforgettable up against anything. That song is hard.
Let's move on a little bit to continue this. So, Young Thug chimed in. He basically said, that's cap.
Yes.
Kendrick. Like, he's like me right now. He's on the team Common Sense. And, let me see if I can pull up what he actually said.
Yeah, like an Instagram video or something like that. Whatever he was talking about.
Yeah, right? Some shit like that. Let's see right. If I play that.
You guys know his name, Kendrick Lamar.
I think.
Fool. Stupid ass nigga said he got no his name, Kendrick Lamar.
I think.
So you know, thug being thug. They were going back and forth on Instagram and Twitter and whatever. I'm not going to really recap what they were doing. Apparently, they have beef from the past with French, like hollering at his wife and shit like that. So, I mean, you know, there's no point of even reporting on that at that point. That's like Meek Safari or
Meek deeper than
Nicki's new man, whatever it is. Like, it's way deeper than that. But I guess 20 for 20, French versus Thug. Now, here's where I want to have the exact same conversation you're having. Because I think Thug is festival records.
Oh, he is.
But I don't think Thug is Kendrick at all.
Oh, no, Thug.
So I think the very same reason why, and you're not saying French beats Kendrick. I'm aware of that. Very aware of that. But in the confines of the conversation of you saying French has a shot against Kendrick is the exact same reason why I'm like, 53% sure, or like I'm like 53-47 French, for the same reason why you think French has a shot against Kendrick.
Young Thug has better club records. Young Thug has better records than French,
but French has bigger records, and we can't discount 05 because Thug is 2015.
And Thug can make a song by himself, which is, let's bring back, French cannot make a song by himself
in a hit battle. It doesn't matter. No disrespect to Hit Boy, but I got all the hits, boy.
I'm still giving it Thug. I think Thug has some hits, man.
He does, but
I think he has more than it. This may be a personal
bias. Do you
think
that battle would be close?
I think it would be close.
I think that's a very tough
maybe I'm giving my personal bias.
You're going a lot of biases there. Like, there's a lot of potential biases there.
I gotta pull up some Thug songs.
I don't
I'm
know.
I'm pretty sure Thug has hits, man.
I don't know. Speaking of not knowing who's gonna win. All right. Wasn't there like a general discussion that I wanted to have about this?
We had a discussion without even knowing.
Oh, yeah.
That was like my argument. It was just the club hits. That was my only argument. That was, and I actually didn't even read that.
That was a serendipitous moment. We had something in our notes to make sure we talk about some shit, and we just talked about it naturally. So speaking of not knowing who's gonna win, Diddy versus Dre, who would you pick?
Dr. Dre?
Yeah.
Dr. Dre.
Okay.
You'll pick Diddy? Well, again, what this goes, are we going to just what they produced?
Well, in it's that their case, catalog. It's their catalog. It's
I don't like, I like, here's just the two different generations, not generations, but like.
No, not.
Diddy has more of a recency bias. Don't I'm saying decency has more.
I would disagree. Kendrick.
I'm giving Kendrick.
You give Dre Kendrick.
Why am I giving Dre Kendrick?
Because like that's produced for him, but that's part of your recency bias.
Oh, I get it.
You see, Dre goes all because you're thinking deep. Dre from the 90s.
That's what I'm thinking of, like Dre right? from the 90s, like.
But he can
Dre never produced Snoop album.
But he can pull out Kendrick.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I got to look into this.
And then Diddy can pull. You know what I'm saying? Like
Diddy has pretty much all of Bad Boy.
It's like I don't know, man.
That's a hard one. Who are you giving it to?
I really don't know.
That's a hard one that I think about.
I am just naturally East Coast biased. So
you're giving it to Diddy.
I have to say Diddy. Like when I think about the biggest East Coast records versus the biggest, let's say like Juicy versus like Gin and Juice.
Juicy got it.
I'm going Juicy.
Mm-hmm, fair enough.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just an East Coast bias.
Yeah.
And I can't hate on anyone who picks Gin and Juice on that.
Okay.
So, you know, obviously that is a battle that has been discussed at this point. It was actually discussed on the Teddy Riley versus Babyface
live battle.
I think Teddy Riley was on either before or after the battle itself. Funny. And he spoke to Dr. Dre. Can't load up the clip right now, but it's fine. He spoke to Dr. Dre, and Dr. Dre's like, I don't know, man. I don't know if I'm really, like, down for that or nothing, man. But I'll think about it, man. I'll think about it, something like that. But essentially where the conversation is heading on really just everyone's talking about it in this way is this something, especially after the Teddy Riley situation? Did you watch that, by the way? Did you see any clips on that? No. Any commentary on that?
All I saw was Teddy Riley had his... Yeah, it was Teddy Riley or Babyface. One of them had their Grammys behind them. That's all I saw.
I actually didn't even watch it. I was just listening to it as I was singing, so I don't know who would have had the Grammys.
Okay. So that's why I only saw a clip.
You know what
but
I'm saying?
One of them had like the Grammys in the like in the Instagram live.
No idea. But to kind of speak to my point rather than to kind of summarize the whole thing, Teddy Riley had a lot of technical issues to a point where they were going to battle on a Saturday. Teddy Riley was trying to simultaneously stream it on his respective side of things, like his website, for example, where it sounded immaculate on there, by the way. But if you saw it on IG, it was so bad that they had to throw in the towel and like, let's reschedule this. This is just not working. It didn't actually happen. Didn't happen on Saturday. Everyone and they mamas was getting ready for Saturday, and it just didn't happen.
So did it happen at all?
500,000 people in the motherfucking room.
I heard.
You know
did it
saying?
Happen at all? Has it happened yet?
It did. It happened, I think, 2 days later. Yeah, it happened on the Monday. No, the Tuesday. Okay. Something like that. And, you know, even with it happening, rescheduled, the sound still wasn't immaculate.
Wasn't the best.
To some degree. And then we talk about RZA versus DJ Premier. RZA was trying to figure out his shit. and shout out to Parks from the Joe Budden podcast for kind of figuring out a solution for them. And then RZA just kind of went back to his ways. So it just kept going back and forth. Yo, hold on. I'm going to try this. 300,000 people in the room.
I hate
watching
that.
Dead air.
Yo, when Quavo was doing that, Quavo was like, oh, why is this shit so blurry?
Oh, man.
I was so cheese. I'm like, yo.
I'm like, fam. Like,
why do you guys not have this figured out before you do it?
Like, but it's like, sometimes it's common sense. Like, everyone get off the Wi-Fi.
Right.
Like,
yelling here, everyone get off the Wi-Fi.
That's it.
Get off the Wi-Fi.
That's all it really is. You know what I'm saying? Edit point. I have no clue what we're talking about.
We're going to talk about...
I was like mid-sentence. I was going to like... I had the last half sentence in my head as I like had the edit point.
And then
like I was going to come back with the other half sentence. But I completely fucking forgot what I said. So, I guess where this discussion is going... Oh yeah, I was describing the whole situation. So yeah, just a bunch of technical difficulties, kind of getting more to the point. A bunch of technical difficulties. DJ Premier and RZA had the same technical difficulties as well. It kind of just begged the question, should this happen off of Instagram Live? Now, remember, we reported about Swiss Beatz and Joe Budden talking.
Mm-hmm.
And Swiss Beatz was saying, you know, this is never going to be something that is for money, right? I mean, obviously, they're going to make a brand from it afterward. Yeah. We already know that.
Not like, directly for money.
Exactly. Just this series of IG battles. going beyond that, Joe Budden and, or who was it? Sorry. Timbaland and Swiss Beats were talking on Instagram Live. And they were talking about Diddy versus Dr. Dre. And they were like, man, that's something that would have to be pay-per-view. Like, all the proceeds would go to da-da-da-da-da. Like, and they were kind of half-joking, but, like, pondering as well. Like, hypothesizing as well. You know what I'm saying? So I guess it kind of just begs the question. Let's I mean, there's always greed involved. But let's assume benefit of the doubt and say this has nothing to do with greed.
Yep. Quote, unquote.
Do you see this something? Do you see this as something that takes its way off of Instagram Live in this current time? I'm not talking about like 3 years from now when it's on Revolt. I'm talking about like right now, like the way it's hot right now. If it were to continue right now, do you ever see some kind of non-IG Live component to it?
Yes, I can see that happening.
I
feel if they can start building the infrastructure. If they haven't already, they should have been building the infrustructure to have this host. Because clearly, you see, Instagram Live gives you, what, the 1 hour limit.
Although sometimes it doesn't.
See, interesting. I don't understand how that works. I know what you're talking
about. I thought they updated it. I'm like, yo, no more hour, da 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 da. And then, like, they cut off Babyface, and I'm like, what the fuck?
Okay. So, anyway, I feel like they should build their own platform to host these type of events that can host 500,000 people without it crashing. I don't know if it crashed. I'm just assuming. But without it being blurry and help the people you're, like, the baby faces and Teddy Riley, you know, like, help them so they're not, it's just not blurry or it's not connecting. Or you
like,
know?
Give them the proper infrastructure.
Like yeah, said, exactly. Right? So I feel like if they take this off Instagram, because right now it's still, like, this, like, it's not this whole Instagram behind it type of thing. And I know it's not really, but technically, because it's streamed on Instagram. It has, like, Instagram behind it.
Right.
Take Instagram away from it. Now it's your thing.
Now, while that's understood...
Now you can make as much money as you want off it, minus greed, but you can make money off it.
Don't you feel like it loses the magic the moment it leaves Instagram?
It does.
Because it does. Part of it is, like, think about it like this. Like, I watched with a few people. Like, shout out to my guys that run the tape and Stephen Thies as well. Like, we're in there. We're in the chat. Mm-hmm. We see each other's comments. Yo, what up? I see you.
Yeah.
You know, shout out Need to Know Podcast as well. Save on Alex, Steph. I see Alex in the comments. Yo, that's Flames. And, like, isn't there something to that?
There is.
You know what I'm saying? And then celebrities are there going at each other.
You see the comments of the celebrities.
And people are screenshotting, yo, Nelly just wants this to play. And Tyrese saying, throw in the
tile. throw in the tile.
Throwing the tile. But doesn't that kind of take, like, it takes it away, in my opinion.
Link
right?
this thing to Instagram? I don't know, man. I'm just talking shit.
I know what you mean.
My unexperienced point of view, but.
I mean, we don't get paid enough to ponder.
If they do want to make money off this, I believe they can.
Yeah.
But I do believe that Instagram is part of the, or a lot of the magic.
Mm-hmm. I agree with that as well.
So they got to somehow include that Instagram, whatever Instagram brings to the table.
When you said help Teddy Riley, Babyface, I was going to say speaking of help, because I had a perfect segue at this point, but the segue is long gone.
Yes.
But the next topic is that Spotify
will
now enable their fans to tip artists via Cash App or PayPal. How do you feel about this?
It is good and bad.
I feel the exact same way.
It's good because I would love to tip my artist, in my opinion.
You should tip her.
Why wouldn't I want to give an artist that you're entertaining me with your music? So here's a little tip. But at the same time, artists have also made it seem like they're just bigger than life, rich people. Like, I wouldn't want to tip the Migos, for example. Because they give me this, like, look at my 6,000 chains and my expensive clothes. Like, you're already showing me non-verbally that you don't need my money.
Okay.
That's how I see it. So that's the only bad
part
of it.
That's the bad part?
Okay. It's like, artists have already, most artists are shown to be, quote-unquote, rich.
Okay. I thought you were possibly going way deeper than that.
Oh, no. That's what I'm going. Where are you going? You go there.
I'm going to go way deeper than that.
Tell me.
Pause. Because we're talking about tips.
pause again.
So, I think the good thing about this is that you get to tip your local artists.
Yeah.
Right? Is, you know, a lot more people, you know, shout out to our guy Cage, episode 97. His shit is on Spotify. You know what I'm saying? $10. I'm gonna talk about an album from a member of, again, Blank Canvas Creatives. Join us on Facebook, and Twitter and Instagram. You already know what it
anywhere.
Is. You know, his name is Cordell Watts. His shit is on Spotify. Mm-hmm. The same way you would listen to any other body of music.
Jay-Z.
So to be able to tip them, there is some value in that. I think the bad part of it is this reminds me a lot of fucking Uber. Uber Eats. You see the Uber shit? Oh, give money directly to your restaurant.
Oh, yeah, that shit is $0.
I saw somebody tweet, I'm buying the food, yeah?
Yes.
I'm giving them a tip, yeah?
It's good. English all of a
I'm paying delivery fee, yeah?
And that's like,
why do I got to give them another fucking, like, why don't you guys pay them Uber? You made $16 billion of profit,
right?
Or revenue or whatever.
It makes no sense.
Why don't you fucking pay them?
It's like, yo, my order is $8. If someone comes up to $16 off Uber and you still want me to pay them.
And now you still want me to give a gratuity because we need you during these times to keep our...
You need them, actually.
Yeah. So how about...
To be honest,
you guys fucking put some money up. Put your money where your motherfucking mouth is.
That's so true.
So it reminds me a lot of that. We talk about Spotify. In fact, before you came through with the family plan, I would have stuck to Tidal. Because the per stream is higher on there. Mm-hmm. And that's my way of supporting artists.
Yeah, I feel you.
Right? I don't do SoundCloud for that reason because they're not getting nothing.
They don't get no money off.
And again, we'll talk about that a little bit later. But like, the company got to do something at some point.
Yeah.
That's really all I'm going with that. Yeah. So yeah,
it's not our problem.
It's good and bad. Again, you know, we can support our peoples, but yo, you platforms have to do better.
They do.
It really comes down to just that. Right?
At the end of the day, the platforms need them.
Yeah, exactly.
Because we can always still buy the CD from Best Buy.
Exactly.
We don't need Spotify, technically. Keep it or leak it?
Yes, sir.
All right, keep you wrote it. This one.
A motherfucking leak it. The first, keep it or leak it. We're talking about Nick Cannon. We're talking about Dr. Sebi. We're talking about Nipsey Hussle. This is... Why would I put the YouTube link? That's a terrible one. the trailer came out, right? Okay. We talked about this, obviously, it being worked on. Then we kind of said, you know, what happened to it? And then we kind of said, oh, no, it's still being worked on.
Yep.
And we now have the trailer. I mean, we all know the answer to this. We just use this as a moment to talk about trailers.
Yeah, it's pretty much.
Keep it or leak it, Nick Cannon, Nipsey Hussle, Dr. Sebi, whatever was being worked on is now complete. Do you want to see it or do you want to keep that shit?
Leak it.
Yeah.
We all know it's
1000% leak. We already know what the fuck
it is. I couldn't even think of a reason why to keep it.
Exactly.
I even tried just because I couldn't.
And this one is just as obvious. Well, maybe it's not, actually. The next keep it or leak it is about our guy Mike Tyson.
Okay.
Right, so Mike Tyson says that he is training again. He said he wants to do exhibition bouts for charity.
Hey.
So I guess I'm going to say keep it or leak it. Do you want to see Mike Tyson back in the ring to an exhibition capacity?
Leak it.
Yeah.
Actually, and I've heard, I don't know how true this is. I've heard that he is itching to, like, he misses, like, boxing. Like, the actual
I get it. Absolutely.
Boxing, like, he actually misses. Supposedly, like, that's one of the things that bothers him the most. Like, he just can't go out and fight. So
yeah.
Maybe this is what his way of kind of acting on his urges. No, not a bad thing. And, you know, helping people at the same time.
Absolutely. So and again, I mean, all he really said was, beyond the exhibition part, I want to get back to training, right? And, you know, for those that do train, like, you'll understand.
Schedule.
There's so many people in training. There's so many people in the gym that don't care to fight ever. They're just great in training. They're great sparring partners. They're great, you know, students of the game. They just don't care to ever fight.
But
so
it's just like the schedule. When I'm training, I'm sticking to
maybe.
A schedule. And it keeps
or that
me-
maybe.
Focused.
But yeah, so for, you know, just for him to say he's training again, absolutely, or wants to train again, that's definitely very enticing of a thought. And yeah, absolutely, I would love to see him back in the ring, because at the end of the day, at the end of the day, the heavyweight pool is not the deepest pool.
It's not anymore.
So I mean, we're talking exhibition fights today, but does something else come from it? Who knows?
Possibly.
Let's get into shout-outs. Now, I wanted to keep this at a shout-out because I did not want to talk about this.
Well, I was going to talk about
personally.
I was going to talk about this.
I'm fucking with you. Kanye West, man. We are going to give a shout-out to Kanye West.
Yes.
Because at the end of the day, we are going to celebrate, you know, Black people
yep.
achieving excellence. So let's give a round of applause for Kanye West for, I guess, officially being claimed as a, or being called a billionaire.
Yes.
That's, yeah, I mean, all I really had was a shout out.
That's all I had too.
I mean, you know, we kind of heard the story of it. We know he's been a billionaire for quite some time now with the Adidas deal. Yeah. But obviously this made it official. He wanted to give documents away, which is very interesting, by the way.
Mm-hmm. 2024. You think he's actually going to run for president?
America's.
Honestly, you know what?
Do you expect anything better from America
I really don't.
Like, before it was a funny, like, oh, Kanye. Now it's like...
Yeah, you know what? You're right. I actually would not be surprised.
So here's my full transparency. Don't ever tell me anything. Because I didn't read the article, but it was saying, like, along the lines of Kanye begging to make sure you understand the full nuances of his deals, which will showcase that he's a billionaire. Yeah, I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you could be on.
Why are you pushing that?
He's opening his book now, so we can all see it.
That's all I'm saying.
You're like, oh, we saw it already. He's not hiding anything.
That's all I'm saying.
Well, shout out to Kanye, though. If he runs out, I'll vote for him. I'm not American, so it doesn't matter if I can't. But, you know, I'll vote for you.
Oh, man. Jeez. Check the YouTube, want to see what just happened. Man. and now you're back, because now your shit just plugged in.
So, did it actually unplug?
Definitely. It's a very finicky wire. So we're going to keep this at a one-take Drake right now. Check our YouTube to watch Shoulder Struggle essentially for the rest of the episode.
You will.
If you pay attention to his right knee, it is holding up the microphone. And the moment that knee falls asleep, his microphone may or may not
be
muted. Into our next break, at least. So let's get into new music. Of course, shout out to Boosie Fade, as usual, for providing that list of new music that has come out for the week. It's quite a busy week, so we will actually get right into it. In terms of albums, we have Mike Dean with 420, assuming that came out last week. We have Kali Uchis, or Uchis. I never know how to say her last name. Uchis, whatever, Uchis, whatever. That one's called To Feel Alive. We have Smino with She Already Decided, which was a mixtape. We have Wiz Khalifa with The Saga of Wiz Khalifa. Guapdad 4000, Platinum Falcon Tape, Volume 1. NBA Youngboy with 38 Baby 2. Favio Foreign, 800 BC. Asher Roth with Flowers on the Weekend.
A lot of shit.
Jungle Brothers with Keep It Jungle.
Jack Boy with Jack Boy.
Yeah, Alina Baraz with It Was Divine. Sky Zoo and Dumbo Station with The Bluest Note.
K-Camp. Yep. Kiss 5. Lil Got It with Hood Baby 2. Nate Smalls with Goat World. Mobb Deep with the infamous 25th anniversary expanded edition.
I wonder where that's on. I wonder if it's on Spotify. I'll be curious about that.
That's all I have for
albums. Yeah, I think that's it for albums. In terms of singles, fucking too many to name.
A lot, honestly.
Run through them. Isaiah Rashad, Why Worry? The Scots, which you will talk about. Yes. That's Travis Scott and Kid Cudi. A self-titled track or whatever the fuck it is. Earl Sweatshirt with Whole World featuring Maxo. Juice WRLD with Righteous. Nav with Pine Sol. JPEG Mafia with Bodyguard, Absol with Danger. What? Danger Rook? What? Who knows? Some shit, some long word. It's a freestyle. Sir with Rapper Weed, Rod Wave with The Last Sad Song, Sir with Rapper Weed featuring Boogie. Okay, it's listed twice. ASAP Ferg with Value, Reason with Might Not Make It. Zakari reached came out with two of them. One of them is called Edamame. Interesting. Edamame. And the other one's called This Woman's Work. Young Dolph with Sunshine. We have K-Camp, probably off of the album Lottery, Renegade, T-Pain remix.
Renegade.
We have Mozzie with Boys to Men. Hobson, holy shit, I haven't seen that name in a while. Wow.
He is still alive? Wow.
That one is called COVID Mansion. We have Lil Pump, your guy, and Annual, how you say that guy's name? Annuala or some shit?
Yeah, something like
Annuela, who knows? That one's called Illuminati. Eric Bellinger came out with Couch Standing featuring Wale and Jeremiah. That sounds like a cheat code of a trio.
Holy shit. Eric Bellinger, Jeremiah.
Wow. Jeremiah is probably one of the best duos that are in hip hop right now. Underrated, low key. T TJX6, Wreck-It Ralph.
Never listened to a song of his, but we always say his name.
Dave East with Handsome. And that's Masego as well came out with Veg Out. That one's also called Wasting Time. Oh, get it? Time as in the vegetable. Let me give Masego that one.
So I get it now. So I didn't see how it's spelled. So I'm like, I don't get it. Wasting time. But now I see it. So let's get to what we listen
to. Yeah, let's get into what we listen to. I'm just watching how often your microphone plugs out at this point. So let's get into what we actually listened to. Now, a lot of fucking music came out. I'm gonna get right into it. And the first project that I want to talk about is a project by DJ Critical Hype. This one is a blend tape, whatever you want to call it. This one came out on Audio Mac. And just to kind of a little bit of backstory behind it. So DJ Critical Hype, he does these blend tapes. For example, he did one with Kendrick and Dr. Dre. He did one with, I'm forgetting the other ones that he's done now. But he announced it for quite a while now that he was working on one with J. Cole and the Neptunes. Okay, and of course, he'll take, you know, one person's bars, put it on the other production's beats, and create a production from it. Makes sense. Now, I had caught wind of this at the time. I saw it being tweeted about. I'm like, when's it coming out? I saw it at the time 2 weeks from now was the timeline on that. And within the next 14 days, basically where I saw that from. Now, I didn't know the name DJ Critical Hype.
I think I've heard of it before.
DJs are, and this is no disrespect, just in terms of abundance, DJs are a dime a dozen.
They are.
To me, because I don't know their names. No one does. So I'm just like, whatever. Like, I'm I'm just a Cole fan. I'm a Neptunes fan. So I'm going to listen to this off the love of music.
Yeah.
Right? A few days later, I see Ibrahim Hamad, the president. Don't do that. President of Dreamville. President of Dreamville. And he basically was like, yo, me and Cole heard this shit. This shit is fire. I'm going to send this guy cleaner version of Cole audio.
So he's using like better versions.
So he's using like official audio. That's the motherfucking president of Dreamville. So yeah. If his audio is not official, I don't know where you're going to find official
Cole audio. Noted.
Right. So he said he was going to do that. And then when it came out, I see Genius like tweeting it and shit. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what the fuck? So like, was this known? Was this hyped? Or did this just catch a lick in a way? Right. But either way, no, it came out. It's not new music, so it doesn't deserve a deep dive per se. But it's just well produced. It's just good music. It's on Audio Mac. Again, it's called DJ. Just look up DJ Critical Hype. I think it's called In Search for Cole, if I'm not mistaken. But look that up. It's a super dope record.
Did you use the 30 happy songs. Beats on any of them?
No, he didn't. But the beats were a lot, not to say a lot, because I know the Neptunes production. The beats were a lot funkier, jiggier than I almost imagined Cole's voice would go on. Like, you know, like the way Tory Lanez is dancing on the quarantine radio.
Yeah.
Like, just like, hold on. Like, I'm just dancing in my house, just listening.
But that's not how Cole's music goes.
I'm just like, what the fuck? I'm just like grooving right now, right? So it was a good listen for sure.
That's good.
I've honestly listened to it, I'm going to say 6 or 7 times.
Oh, damn. How many tracks? At least,
we're talking 30 songs.
Jeez.
So this is a very long project. I'm sure some songs are shortened in some ways. But, I mean, we're talking still, at least an hour's worth of a project. It's still 30 songs, like you said. I thoroughly enjoyed that. Again, DJ Critical Hype. It's a blend tape fusing J. Cole's lyrics with the Neptunes production. I'm going to highly recommend everyone go listen to that. Exclusive to Audio Mac. Super dope. Go listen to it. The next project I'm going to talk about before we kind of get into a little bit more general conversation is a project by a member of a Facebook community that I've been talking about for quite some time. The Facebook community is called Blank Canvas Creatives. Canvas is spelled with a K. So BKC is kind of the hashtag for it, the acronym, so to speak. You know, it's a collective, obviously, that I am a part of, that we are a part of. A
collective.
And it's ready to catch steam. Jeez. Right? We have rappers in there. We have producers in there. We have poets in there. Podcasters. People who do blogs. people who run different types of businesses. It's all art in there, man. You know, digital content creators, social. You know what I mean? We have all different types of creators in there. It's a platform by creators. It's for creators, mm-hmm. and really what it's trying to be is, can we be a platform that breaks other artists? And I'm using artists in the most general way possible. Yeah. Creatives, I guess. Can we be a platform that breaks creatives regularly? Mm. That's essentially where the vision is going. Okay. Right. So we do have a rapper in there. His name is Cordell Watts. Jeez, that was Cordell Watts. He came up with a project. And actually, I think you would like this. I really do think you would fuck with it. It's called Cry Now, Laugh Later. So, you know, just ready to face on all the motherfucking feelings and emotion and all that kind of stuff. Hip hop, rapping type of thing. I think he's from Brooklyn, if I'm not mistaken. Shout I think out to he said. Brooklyn, we go hard. The reason I know that is he has a song on there called East Atlanta Joint or something like that.
East Atlanta Squeeze.
East Atlanta Squeeze. And I'm like, yo, you from Atlanta? He's like, nah, I just had a ting from Atlanta.
I had a ting back there. I'm
dead. And I get it. I'm not mad at that. But no, like I said, man, you know, we're really trying to rev up and put our money where our mouth is. So, jeez. You know, he's
have money.
Putting that project out and letting all of us know about it. And we're saying, hey, you know what? I'm going to take it to our platform and we're going to talk about it. And we're going to try to spread this word as much as possible. Cordell Watts. This is 20 songs at 1 hour.
Is this his first song? I'm assuming this is his first project.
I don't personally know.
Okay.
I'm not going to lie.
That's fine.
But yeah, it's on Spotify. Let me actually just load it up here so I can kind of play back some records. Because, I mean, he ain't going to block our shit.
That's what you say now.
Cordell, meanwhile,
Cordell Watts.
The whole episode is gone. Fuck.
It removes your episode.
So I'm going to play the intro. This one is called Cry Now, the intro.
Stop, think there's no way I should be flying business, but the kid got it on my way to the A. Once I land, I text Shay. I know another girl, she vicious, real name Sade. Been out of my mind lately, since been going, not even worthy of me even putting your name.
I'm going to stop it there for a moment. Again, it's starting slower, I guess, is where I'm going with that. Hold on. I'm just multitasking here. It's starting slower, which I do really like about the project. It kind of fits the name of the record itself, Cry Now, Laugh Later. He's ready to take on these emotions. He's ready mm-hmm. to cry now and go through it.
Yep, laugh at the end.
You know, just even just the title of it, the sound, the lyricism, it felt very true to the title. It felt like it was definitely setting the tone, which is what I like. The next song on there is called Where's the Love? And the love, I forget the name of the sample of this, but
Black Eyed Peas, Where's the Love?
No. Fabulous used this one on one of his mixtapes.
Your lunch corpses. When I enter this metamorphosis, America's nightmare. When I enter these corporate offices, my shit bangs. Niggas frontin', I leave your brain stained, cold vein. Either rapper into the dope game. Niggas act awfully funny when success comes. People rather do the most emasculated love. I got K's, I got Nas, I got slugs. Never afraid to take it there. I'm asking where's the love.
I'm asking where's the love.
So I like the musical prowess that you show when you can get into the sample bag, yeah. Right? Yeah. Or even
he does
just
sound a lot like New York too. I can hear it in New York,
and you hear that kind of New York mixtape yes. type of feel with something like this, even on that kind of beat, like yeah. the soul samples and whatnot. So you know, you really like to see that kind of depth involved in that type of project, in the project as a whole. Like I said, track 6 is called East Atlanta Squeeze. That was an early favorite for me as I was listening to the album. I'll play a little bit of that.
My diet shorty working, jerking nonstop. Gave a deep stroke, she said don't stop. Yeah, I beat it up like a quarter op. Getting real loud, they might call a cop. Saying real slow, so I know it's real. Shouldn't be fucking, but you know the deal. Baby, meet me midnight by my hotel. When my sunrise, I was just a kill.
Able to switch up his flow.
Yeah,
right? That. So on the previous track, you're like, oh, I can hear the New York sound. I don't hear it with this. I hear the boppier, I guess.
You know, that New York accent, they don't lose that shit, man.
That's true.
That shit is everywhere they go. It's just the way they sound. It sounds hard for no reason.
He has another song on here called Betcha.
Betcha Won't.
It sounds like, I swear to God, I thought it was Diddy and Mace.
Damn, that's a Diddy and Mace.
It has that 90s groove to it. Let me play that one.
The only thing that keep me functional, can't stand still for too long. Yo, what I'm gonna do is dark, flick and tear my chest up, and be dysfunctional, untouchable, to mass combustible, indestructible.
motherfucker.
That saxophone is hard. That sax is hard.
Hard. Ooh, yeah. I was feeling that. What I will say, just to kind of close out the review on this, for it being 20 records, he spazzed at the end. Like 17, 18, 19, 20. Nice. I don't want to take too long on this because we have a lot of music to review, but I'm going to play a little bit of 17. This one's called Enough.
Pretty hoes, if you ain't getting money, I ain't judge a nigga. Stay your ass home. Okay. I only pull up for the do same. Shout out to neighborhood Chris.
Even the beat tells you he's about to go hard on that. The next one is called Deathbeds. I'm sorry. This is one special. You can tell this is one of those records that he's probably going to remember for the rest of his life.
Jeez. Like that, and if I did, that's my lowest. 12 years later, I'm playing with women's emotions. Look, abortions and the plan B is not considering how they feel. Now I'm laying by myself, about to die. Now I'm in my feels. Bridges burn, feels burned. I guess I never learned.
Oh, there was supposed to be a line that I was supposed to play. Play it from halfway. Hold on.
She didn't know that I'm sorry. For all the nights that I left you hurt.
You're right. Because track 19 was that track.
I like these rappers that do the most for the clout.
Yeah, right here.
Unreasonable doubt. Nothing like these rappers that do the most for the clout. Nothing like these rappers that came up still in the sound. Career crashed the burn. I guess he took the dummy route. Caught a lucky hit. Where he at now?
Dummy? Tekashi?
I'm dead.
This guy just
got it now.
So, you know, again, just showing knowledge when it comes to how to rap, when it comes to how to put music together. I did enjoy this project. In terms of some of the subject matter, I saw some similarities to Boogie.
Okay.
Everything for Sale. Jeez. Kind of along that realm. That's why I said that you would probably fuck with some of this record for sure, because it had some of that feel to it. But at the same time, you know, like at first I was thinking this album feels like it's in that heartbreak realm.
Okay.
But I feel like he gave me a little bit more than that. I feel like I was, you know, I was bopping to some records. I was like, okay, he's getting introspective on these records. This one's a little bit more club-esque. This one's a little bit more breakup with your girl. Yeah. This one's a little bit more fuck that girl. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So like it. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I just, you know, misinterpreted it. But I felt like that was kind of an additional layer that I enjoyed about the album. So I'm going to recommend all the listeners look that one up. That one's, again, called Cry Now, Laugh Later by Cordell Watts. Definitely a member of Blank Canvas Creatives. Follow that movement, BKC Network on Twitter, BKC Network on Instagram, and look up Blank Canvas Creatives on Facebook. Again, that's Canvas with a K. So yeah, worth a listen for sure. Where else are we going to go here? So the next series of projects we're going to talk about, we definitely did not listen to in depth, or at least not enough to give a in-depth review on.
Yes,
very least. Where do I want to start? I want to start with Kali Ulkis.
Olex.
You know what? I feel like I'm playing Word Hunt where you're just looking for words. Ulkis. 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 Anyways. She's an R&B singer.
I listened to this.
You did listen to this?
Yeah. Because it was four songs. Like, you know, okay.
Interesting.
In and out quick.
Wow. Pause. I'm at a loss for words. I'm at a loss for words. Four songs, 10 minutes. You know what? She's good.
I see her talent, good project. Though. I do see her talent. Because it wasn't 2 years ago that she was supposed to win Album of the Year. She was nominated for Album of the Year.
I really don't know.
There was one of those years that she was nominated for like a lot of Album of the Years.
Mm-hmm.
I can see her talent. Like, she is talented.
She's really good.
I respect it.
Very enjoyable project. That one's called To Feel Alive. It is an EP. Go listen to that one. Did you listen to Guap Dat 4000?
No, I didn't even know he dropped something.
You should. You'd like it.
I feel like I would. I've never actually listened to any of his like tapes.
He's one of those people where he's almost like... I'll give you a perfect example. He is a B-class version of Vince Staples to me.
Okay, I like that.
And where I'm going with that is not even stylistically.
Oh, okay. Well, that's where I was going with that.
I know, exactly. Because there is some, to some degree, stylistic comparison as well. But I like the celebrity more than I like the music.
See, and that's, I feel like I've heard more about Guap 4000 than I've actually listened to any of his music. Like, I've seen him places, I've heard of him.
B-class version of him. You know what I'm saying?
So I've never actually listened to a whole tape from him.
Guap Dad 4000 is somewhere between I'm only doing fun rap and I sound like Earthgang and JID. He's somewhere in between. Like, I can't figure out if to take him seriously in terms of his lyrics or if it's just fun shit or if it's both, right? So it's enjoyable. You know, none of these projects blew me away this week per se. It was just a really good week of music in general. But that one I actually listened to twice. So it's worth a listen in my opinion. Platinum Falcon Tape. Volume 1. I'll play a little bit of that one so you get an idea of how he sounds.
Yeah, I have no idea how he sounds, to be honest. And I've heard him on a feature before.
And you're like, you don't know which one is him on the feature.
I remember which one is him.
Real shit. So this one is actually a feature with, hold on, where is it here? Platinum Falcon.
With a buddy?
Yes.
How did I know?
Yes. No, I lied.
Damn it.
I lied. Which one was I going to play?
The one I said.
I actually don't even know where my shit is right now. Hold on. Too much fucking music came out.
You had no songs. You just had
I didn't have anything to play, but I'm going to play a little bit of this one. This one's called Peanut Butter Pootie Tang.
Cheers.
I'm riding in the rocket ship, sock it to my pockets like some Takis, got a lot of chips. Nerd and I need a freak, bitch, you need dick. These niggas wanna hate me for my comments, they debate me for my comments. Fashion Nova fucking pay me for my comments. Shit, raising up my comments, put the pussy.
You get what I'm saying? It's like, are you fun or are you saying shit?
Yeah, I know.
Like, Fashion Nova fucking pay me for my comments, bit. You know, like he's saying
real?
Shit.
Like, yeah. Did you comment and didn't pay you, or are you just saying that just for fun?
I really don't know. But no, that was an enjoyable project. Again, a lot of shorter projects came out this week, which I really liked. This one was 6 songs at 17 minutes. A fun record. Fun, sillier type of record where you get those types of names.
And speaking of fun records.
Go ahead.
Thivio Foreign.
I didn't even get to that. There's so much music
BC.
Came out.
It was good, man.
That was like EP variety, right? Like,
yeah, it was 8 songs, 24 minutes.
Okay, I'm going to go to that.
I liked it. Meek was featured on one song.
My assumption was Meek that I had to be outside to listen to this.
You do, man. You need to be like, you need to be moving.
And that's
this.
Why I didn't listen to it, but, I guess.
It's nice, man. I've listened to it like twice already.
The weather this week is nice,
though. And Meek sounds good. Meek sounds like he was meant to be a hype rapper, man.
Yeah.
Like he sounds so good on these tracks. I'm like,
Meek figured it out, man. He did. I'm glad he did.
First track, Drive By. It gives you exactly what you want from Fivio Foreign. Like, you know what you're getting.
Exactly what I think it sounds like.
That's exactly what I think it sounds like. It's what it is. And it's hard, man. I like it. It's straight New York drill, this whole mixtape.
Okay, yeah.
He has a future, man. He has a future.
For sure.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to Youngboy? NBA Youngboy?
I did not listen to it. Or did you listen to it?
I did not.
And I'm probably not going to listen to it.
I won't either.
And I did a quick count on Spotify.
Okay.
So between 2018 and now, he's dropped 9 projects.
You got to give it to him, man. Listen, at the end of the day, I will always respect someone's craft. Mm-hmm. And NBA Youngboy will go down as the next Gucci. Like it's,
he will.
You know he will. Like that he's going down as the next Gucci.
That is what he's doing.
And Gucci backs him too. You know what I'm saying?
Gucci does back him.
So that comparison is inevitable at some point if it's not already being made.
Hey.
He does the numbers on YouTube, like.
So I was gonna say, is this like, are we missing what the kids are seeing in him?
No, I just think it's a generational difference, right? Like with the Travis Scott shit, there's 12 million people on Fortnite watching it. Appreciate that. I will watch the clips all day.
I will not download
Fortnite to go play that.
No,
or be a part of that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's just a generational thing, and I think it's okay to. Not see what they're seeing.
True.
It's just up to whether or not you're going to choose to be ignorant about it. I'm not Youngboy's garbage. I don't get it.
I do see a little bit of music.
I get it. Not for me.
Exactly.
But I get why he has an audience.
Fair enough.
You know what I'm saying? Sky Zoo came out with the bluest...
The bluest Noir?
Holy shit, my bad.
I hope you meant Noir.
I fucking typoed that shit, yo.
You talk about it, I'll Google it.
Yeah. So this one, Sky Zoo, I want to shout out to Run the Tape Podcast.
The biggest Cozy, note, sorry.
Biggest note.
Yes.
Cozy, Uchechi, Run the Tape Podcast, of course. Shout they are the a New York podcast discussing hip hop. And I've always appreciated from their show that they're so pure with their commentary. Mm. And they put me on to a lot of artists.
Okay.
And then Sky Zoo was one of those artists that they put me on to. a New York rapper. And at the time, this was when Skyzoo came out with his project with Pete Rock. And obviously, I'm going to respect Pete Rock from a production standpoint. Yep. So, I mean, I thoroughly enjoyed that project last year. So I said, obviously, I'm going to listen to Skyzoo with whatever else he comes out with. And this was just hella solid. To give you a little bit of an idea of Skyzoo, just clean, reliable New York rap.
Okay.
I don't really know how to describe it other than that, right? Let me play a little bit of whatever, play a random track. Off the album, of course.
Yeah, I figured.
Delivered and kick it to you in the past.
No, I don't want
to
play that one. I want
to. He's like, that's not doing him justice.
Daft Punk, praise, her friends do shade. I don't get tight about it, they just want bouquets. Her friends sell hair, my friends sell dope. Told her all I ask is don't go out with your nails broke. She do group calls, I do cigar nights. She let me breathe soon as she see the cigar light. I read Ta-Nehisi, I read Don Diva. She see the conflict and says that I'm all keeper. She wear time slides.
Just, again, reliable. Okay. Reliable music. When you it say, is. Yo, I don't even know what I want to listen to right now. Skyzoo, play, I'm enjoying myself. You know what I'm saying? I'm not anticipating one track too much. I'm not saying any one track is too garbage where I got to skip it. It's just good reliable music.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So Skyzoo, definitely go listen to that one, The Bluest Note. I enjoyed it. Did you want Wiz Khalifa shit?
I did, actually. I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it, too.
I really enjoyed the Wiz Khalifa
stuff. I'm like, yo, I don't think we're appreciating Wiz.
Yeah, I was thinking about the concert where I'm like, damn, do we really walk out on Wiz set?
I mean, we only walked out because the circumstances were bad.
It was, yeah.
It wasn't because we're like, Wiz is trash. No, it was like fucking storming. White kids were mosh pitting.
That's true. It was storming that day.
Not
was
mosh pitting. They were like dancing in the rain and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, that's true. You're right.
Otherwise, I would have stayed, obviously. Yeah, like, I'm not going to pay for something and leave. The well, fuck?
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? That don't make no sense. But that was also a short one. 7 songs, 20 minutes. And somehow, some way, Wiz Khalifa just always manages to successfully find himself building the perfect playlist music,
right?
The perfect streaming music, mm-hmm. The perfect, I'm going to put it in an anime film, type of music, the perfect soundtrack, Grammy nominated type of music. Like,
that's Wiz Khalifa.
It just somehow, some way, always finds itself in that lane.
And
so,
this is what this EP did, the Saga of Wiz Khalifa.
Yeah, Saga of Wiz Khalifa. I think it's worth a listen. Again,
7 tracks, 20
pretty
minutes.
Fucking reliable music. Then that was kind of the theme of this week, was that
we got good, reliable music
across the board.
Yes,
in every genre. Kali Uchis, reliable. Wiz, reliable. Skyzoo, mm-hmm. reliable. Moving on to another reliable project, let's talk about Asher Roth.
You tell me about Asher Roth, because I'm not playing Asher Roth.
I thought you would think that, and to some degree, I thought I would think that because, I mean, and this is no disrespect to Asher Roth because he was dope at the time, but it was the one DJ Drama tape.
It was,
let's be
exactly.
honest, right? At least from a public notoriety perspective, or at least a public perception perspective, yeah. right? This one, 12 songs, 34 minutes, so it's a little bit more of the fuller length type mm-hmm. of thing. I enjoyed it.
Okay.
Now, sometimes I intentionally play things when you come in.
Yes.
You looked at the TV 4 times.
I did.
That was Asher Roth the entire time.
I didn't look at it because I looked at it for a few things.
Okay, tell me why you looked at it.
I heard Buddy's voice.
Okay, fair.
And, you know,
and Buddy's
fan.
On one of the songs.
So I look at him like, yo, why is Buddy playing on
okay.
the TV? Two, there's a few songs I did not like him on.
Mm.
And I heard it and I was like,
I think I know which
I gotta
one
look back
you're
and like,
thinking
yo, that's
of.
It.
Okay.
I from what he played, I didn't like this album.
Okay, fair.
But it's what I expected from Asher Roth.
No,
but
and I can't hate on that. I can't hate on that.
I didn't
at all.
Like I didn't go into this expecting to like it and not like mm-hmm. it. It's Asher Roth. I don't listen to Asher Roth because of this.
Yeah. I didn't particularly have a perceptive thought of what I thought
yeah.
this project would be. I just wanted to press play and see where we
but
go.
But you
from
liked
there.
It, right?
I mean, track one kind of caught me.
Okay, maybe I'll just track one.
Just
maybe
with, like, again, I'm talking about what realm, what kind of spectrum of hip-hop is it? It's kind of in that somewhat
hip-hop?
Lo-fi, somewhat alternative. I don't really know how to describe it, but I thought to myself with this project, I almost stole my own point with talking about Skyzoo. This is a very reliable project. Mm. Maybe you tell me, because this could have been a real life situation. You weren't really feeling some of the songs.
Yeah.
Was it painful for your ears at any point?
It's the way he raps.
Okay.
There's a certain flow he has that it doesn't sound like he's even trying to rap. It almost sounds like he's just talking to a
man. And that's what I like about
him. And that's what I hate about him. Like, yo, that's like no talent.
Yeah. Well, hey, that's actually a lot of talent.
I went down the street and...
Your guy Donald Glover did the same thing on the Sway freestyle. What are you talking about?
Again, that's a freestyle, though. It's not a track. That was probably written. It's not a well-produced, mixed and mastered album track.
I mean, albums aren't that nowadays. Albums are just bodies of music nowadays. True.
But you know what I'm saying. Like, it was a put-out work. It wasn't a...
Yeah. No, I mean, but I mean, nonetheless, again, I can't hate on that at all. Because, again, we're talking about an opinion of one thing. The one thing you dislike is the one thing I like. Exactly. Right? But nonetheless, what you're getting from this project... little bit more relaxed. It's a little bit of a groovier type of alternative type of somewhat lo-fi type of hip hop.
Okay.
Or at least it's on kind of that spectrum of it. And like I said, it's just, it's reliable music to kind of play in multiple different settings. Mm-hmm. I think it's worth the listen for sure. That one is called Flowers on the Weekend. I'm going to play a little bit of that Buddy track just to kind of get an idea of as to what this project sounds like. And this one's called Spaceship. And this was actually probably top two song on the album for me. That's right. If not like favorite.
Making niggas hating pants sagging, but he is the namesake. Niggas say.
I came in with him saying niggas. It was Asher Roth saying niggas. Whoa, hold up. No, that's Asher Buddy, guys. Song? That's Buddy. Let me see if I can get an Asher Roth verse. That was heavy.
Generation extra fear, Metal Gear Solid Model T must got us believing in false prophets, leaving it all behind us, free from all the gossip.
That's kind of what I like about Roth, though, is his effortlessness. Even when he was rhyming on the DJ Drama shit, that's what made it so cool to me, was that...
his effortlessness?
It was too effortless, you know what I'm saying? Right. But no, that was a good project. I think it's pretty reliable, and I can see myself going back to that several times. And
let me talk about Nave Smalls quickly.
Yeah, please do.
Nave Smalls came out with Goat World. He's a UK artist. First time I heard him was actually on Skepta's track. He was featured on Skepta's track, and I liked his voice.
Yep.
Then I saw his name on the BKC, or the, not BKC list.
Boosie Fade.
Yeah, the Boosie Fade.
New music list.
I was like, oh, well, why not?
Well, I'm going to listen to it.
I enjoyed this project. It's 14 songs, 49 minutes, so it's full length. 1 to 3, you're getting your sing-song Nave. He has like this rapper singing thing he does.
Okay, okay, okay.
And then all of a sudden, he just switched up and gave me like a reggae song out of nowhere.
Mm. Like Akon. Like, what are you doing, Akon?
It didn't sound bad, but it also didn't sound like it was natural for him. It sounded like he was trying hard.
Like Akon.
Yes, like Akon. Track number 8, Home Run. That beat is fire. I love that beat. Track number 10, his feature, Mira May was her name. Yep, Myra May. She sounded so good. And
her name is Myra May?
Or Mira May. Yes. Mira May.
Well, it's M-I-R-A-A-M-A-Y.
Oh.
So it's Mira or Myra.
I just watch. I'd be watching too much fucking Money Heist.
Yes.
Look at me. Look at me. Mira May. Mira May.
Look at me.
Mira May.
Overall, he sounds... honestly, he has a sound that can get generic.
Okay.
But on this album, he was able to differentiate his style. He showed us different...
he kept you hooked long
enough. Yes. Like one song, he was like trying to do a sing, like sing thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's not the best singer, but you know, I give him A for effort. He tried a thing. One of them, he was like doing like a rap. You know, again, A for effort. He's not like the best at anything, but he's above average at everything he does. He does sound polished, which I like.
Okay.
His production sounds polished. He knows what he's doing in the studio. And I'll give this project a really good... I've been to it twice. On two listens, I'll give it like a 7, 6.5, 7 out of 10. It's not bad, but again, it's good music.
Right.
It's
holy fuck. We got a lot of fucking music to talk about. This is crazy.
And then I think
holy shit. Okay.
Tell me about Smino. Is that last album we have?
No. It's not. We have more after that. Yeah, but I know. I will tell you about Smino though. Okay. So Smino came out with a mixtape. This one's called She Already Decided. Now he mentioned on Instagram Live, he was on Instagram Live with some kind of music platform. I forgot exactly who, and they had asked him, they were doing a Q&A with him, and they said, is this going to come out on DSPs? And he's like, you know, probably not, sample clearing and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And from a music fan perspective, that made me say, yeah, I think I'm going to listen to this.
Jeez.
Cause you know, you're going to get some shit that you recognize, mm-hmm. right?
That's true. Did you get something you recognize?
You definitely got some stuff that you recognize on this. I actually went to SoundCloud for this. You know how I feel about SoundCloud. I fucking hate SoundCloud with my goddamn life. But I said, you know what? Like, especially after what DJ Critical Hype did with the J. Cole project, and we ain't got shit else to do in this motherfucking quarantine. Like I said, I've been going on a little bit more music discoveries, music deep dives. I'm not going to be that stingy in a way where it's like, fuck that. I'm not like, no, yeah, I feel like I've been craving some new Smino pause. Like, yeah. I've been bumping noir coincidentally these past couple weeks,
yeah, I've been.
Obviously. Right. So in terms of getting something familiar, I'll give you a little bit of this one. Where is it? Oops.
SoundCloud for you.
Put booty in that motherfucker. Oh God, you hit the target up, nigga. That's the whole club, nigga.
Slide on me, eject Ocito, no Fasmino, let her fuck my homie. I'm from a nigga, no tuxedo, my air for wine on me. Bitch, I stay puffy like a Cheeto, got took his time on me.
Okay.
I stay puffy like a Cheeto, got took his time on me.
Jeez, yo, Smino, like that.
He's an alien, man. His flow is just so alien-esque, it's crazy. And because it is a mixtape, I'm not going to do an in-depth deep dive on it. But just go listen to that.
I actually like that. Just that Smino, song you played sold me on him.
Smino is amazing. What else do we fucking have to
Alicia,
talk about?
Alicia.
No, it's Alina.
Alina Baraz.
Alina Baraz. Let's talk about Alina Baraz. Wait, no, there's something else I wanted to talk about. Hold on.
And there's a few singles.
I don't want to talk about the singles at all. I just wanted to quickly mention with everything that TDE is coming out with, Isaiah Rashad, Sir Absol, and Reason, and Zachary. Or Zakari? They literally all came out with songs.
And Ari Lennox. Oh, Ari Lennox is not part of them, sorry.
But I wonder if there's some kind of cross-platform promo going on right now, because with Reason's single, he mentioned SZA and Ari.
Jeez.
The way many people have, the way we all have. I mean, I'm not going to finish that sentence.
We won't mention them.
Because we got to keep our, you know, we got to keep our platform clean. Yeah, you know what I mean? But Ari Lennox tweeted, also, you wish at Reason, you sexist trifling ass.
Damn.
And then J.I.D. tweeted this.
No cap.
That's Ari.
Ari Lennox saying no cap. So obviously you like the camaraderie that goes on with these two labels. And I like 5 TDE artists coming out with singles at the same time. I thought that was just worth mentioning, worth noting. And that's all I'm going to say on that. Next album I'm going to talk about now is Alina Baraz. Let's talk about Anika Tanya Baraz. Let's talk about Alina Tanya Baraz. No, I want to talk about this Alina Baraz project. Every once in a while, I stumble upon music and I really ask myself, how did I stumble upon this?
How did you find Alina Baraz Minaj?
So, you know, when you open Spotify and it suggests an album or an artist?
Yeah.
It's always a dismiss for me.
It's always
me. Either I've already listened to it.
Or I don't care.
Or I don't care that Khalid came out with a new album. Okay?
Yes,
I really
you
don't.
Do. You know you love him.
So here goes Spotify again. What's brand Spotify? New Alina Baraz. I'm like, who is Alina Baraz, fam? Like, who are you selling me on now?
They sold you.
For whatever reason, I was just like, you know what? Let me click the name. I mean, maybe the album cover sold me on it.
Yeah, it happened.
Not even hard. She's just a very beautiful woman, if that is her on the cover. But I looked it up, so I seen it was Divine Alina Baraz, right? So I'm like, okay, we have 16 records, so this is a real album, 52 minutes, okay. I see track number 2 featuring Black. I'm like, ooh, okay.
Like, but, 6 Black Black?
Yeah. Okay. But Black hops on everyone's shit.
Honestly, he's like the new $10 sign.
Track 5 featuring Smino.
Oh, he don't know about it. He off on everybody's shit.
I have not seen Smino on any features. I'm bullshitting, obviously. But track 6, Khalid, which I'm not going to discount Khalid as a feature artist.
Just discount him as an artist.
Yes. And then I saw track 15 featuring Nas. And I'm like, okay, hold on.
Hold up. Who is she?
Who's a download? So I downloaded it. I pressed play on track 1. And this one's called My Whole Life. And I'm like, okay, we're getting R&B. We're in that realm of R&B. This is exactly my subgenre. This is the Janae, the Snow, the fucking, Cali Uchis. Like, this is that subgenre of R&B. Like, I fuck with it, right? So I listened to the project a couple of times. First, I just let it play through. And I'm wondering, I almost asked myself if this is going to be a new strategy for me going forward. Let it play through with no thought or even listening. Just let it play. And then go back and be like, okay, track eight, what was he saying on that? Track two, what was she saying?
Oh, that, I always do that.
Because usually, like, I'll listen and I'll dissect. Like,
no, I don't do that
from
immediately.
Gate, from jump.
I can't do that immediately. I need to subconsciously know if I like this song.
That's what
I can say. Because I put a lot of songs on my mixtape. On my playlist. So, like, the first time I made my playlist, I'm going to notice I'm putting half a song, half an album, and I'm deleting half the songs I put because I don't even like them.
Exactly.
And that's when I'm like, you know, I'm rushing too much.
You're and trying to get the playlist count. Like, take your time.
Exactly. Like, let me make sure, like, I'm like three songs I actually want to play back to back to back to back from the song. I don't even listen to 20 songs.
Yeah, so, you know, looking at the feature list and listening to track one, I immediately gave it the chance that I wanted to give it, right? And it's what I wanted it to be. It's kind of in that, again, reliable lane of R&B music, R&B music that I can go back to several times when I go back and, or if I start talking about, yo, let me put you on some R&B for 2020, she would be one of the names that come up. You know what I'm saying? So I really enjoyed this project. It was called It Was Divine by Alina Baraz.
She's good on the eyes.
Yeah, I'm gonna play a little bit of that Smino track because Smino is just an alien.
Make a man try and diss it, huh? Whoa. I'm kind of country, you like my sliders. I stretch you out like my ease and eyes.
Don't be worried, I come through for her.
Seen the Baraz while I lean on her.
Cape in the park, handcuff, I keep my chains on. Land on your thighs, I like the blood. Got stripes on my wall. Get it from the bed, like full of it.
You know? You're talking about Alina Baraz, but you played only the Smino part. I'm dying.
Because Smino's an alien. I said I'm going to do that, right?
Yeah. Let me just end this quickly.
I did it with my chest.
We're talking about two singles.
Please do.
First one is Juice WRLD's Righteous.
Yep.
I'm against post-humorous.
Post-mortem or post-hummus, humorous?
Whatever.
We're not trying to be funny. We actually don't know.
Exactly. I'm not for those albums just because I feel like I'm not getting the artist's input.
Mm-hmm.
But I do like this. Juice WRLD's voice is still amazing. And you can hear the ascension in his voice, which I've always loved about him. So RIP to Juice WRLD, song's fire.
Mm.
If you like Juice WRLD, you'll like this song. Last song is The Scots by Travis Scott and Kid Mescudi. Scott Mescudi.
Scots.
For you guys who want to know where the other Scott came from.
Yep.
Like you alluded to earlier, the Fortnite release.
Yeah.
Which, it looks sick, to be honest.
It looked fucking sick.
Not even like, if I was a 12-year-old kid, I would have been on Fortnite.
Oh, man. There was one of the clips where, obviously, one of the drops of one of the bigger songs. And then the guy flew back.
Yeah, that's just sick.
I was like, yeah. I was like,
and yo. And the guy started running back. That was
holy,
sick.
Holy. I was like, I was like, hold on.
Hold on.
I was like this. Yeah. Every time it happened,
it was sick.
Hold on.
I don't think we used any sound bites this episode, yeah, so I got to make sure I do it for the culture.
True.
Go on.
It was a combo I didn't think I needed, or I didn't know I needed
until
I heard it. I was like, bro, this song sounds sick. Amplified guitar, crazy. The synth at the end. So shout out to Mike Dean. For you guys who don't know, he's a good music producer.
Yep.
He is known for his synths. And anytime you hear a synth in a Kanye or any good music record, he's probably involved with it. So which means he probably produced this track. I didn't look into it. They both sound amazing. And supposedly, I was going to put this in Keep It Leak, but I want to surprise you. A project is coming soon.
Keep It Leak. Well, let's say leak that because here's the thing.
Did you hear the song?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
I'm almost, not to say running back because I didn't really waver on one side or the other, but I'm going to use it because I can't find any better words. I'm almost running back my fake hatred for Travis Scott the same way I ran it back for Quavo.
The fake hatred.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
fake hatred. Yeah, I get it.
Whenever I get a Quavo feature now,
I'm like, yo, it's hard.
I'm blasting it. The Travis Scott clips were fire.
They were.
So I want leak that. Leak that. That's 100% leak.
Shout out.
1,000%. And you talked about Mike Dean, and I know we talked about this in New Music, but just for you mentioning that, I think it's worth downloading.
His 420.
His
420. I didn't even know. Honestly,
came out last week, of course.
You read it, I totally missed it too.
Yeah, and even as I said it, like it didn't really click. So, like, I'm gonna
listen to that.
It's a bunch of unnamed track. The fifth day, part one, part two, part three.
Yeah,
part.
He's a producer. They always do stuff.
Exactly.
Like that. They create so much stuff.
They just
throw random names.
They're all file names. It's part of the culture in a lot of ways. Did we somehow get through all the music?
We did.
Holy, that was draining.
That was.
Take a breath, fam. Anyways, let's talk about what's in our rotation. Let's finish off this segment. Do you want to go first or do I want to go first?
I will go first.
Please do.
All right. Where do we start this week at? Ghetto Gospel by Rod Wave stays in the rotation.
Yep.
This is Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Still
in the rotation.
Not
nice,
mad at that.
Nice alternative music, you know?
Yep.
Revenge of the Beast by King's Dead. Older music. This came out like 2012. They're from Boston. Heavy's the Head by Stormzy. Young Ma. He came out with an album called Six Rings.
Okay.
I listened to like part of it. There's one song I heard and I really like.
Is Young spelled Y-U-N-G?
Yes, you've seen it before.
I feel like, yeah.
Because I've seen it too before, but I finally heard a song from him. I never heard a song from him. And I just see his name. And I was like, yo, so I'm going to go listen to his album or mixtape called Six Rings. It's all right. Before Love Came to Kill Us by Jesse Reyes.
Are you bumming the deluxe?
No, it wasn't the deluxe version.
Should.
Because I didn't have the deluxe version downloaded, only the OG version.
So I know I like the OG cover better.
Oh, she changed the cover too in the deluxe?
She changed the cover.
Damn, okay, I gotta look at it now.
It's not as fire.
Damn.
I just gotta say that, Jesse Reyes, in case you're listening. You always gotta say in case you're listening.
In case you're listening, that's true.
You never know what can get out to people.
This is Juice WRLD.
Okay.
I bumped a lot of that. I'm gonna say Go World because I bumped it twice and it's a long tape, it's 20 songs. And, Sweet Action by Jack Harlow. That came up. And yeah, that's about where it ends.
Okay. Not mad at that.
Actually, I'll say The Saga by Wiz Khalifa because I bumped that twice too.
Yeah.
And I actually like that a lot more than I thought I would.
Me too.
Yes.
Me too in a lot of ways. Not mad at that. Okay.
So tell me what's in your rotation.
My rotation, well, I'm going to start with the non-Spotify stuff first. Hopefully I can get used to doing that going forward. Yeah, like I said, DJ Critical Hype. That's definitely in my rotation. I go to that kind of when I want to party on a Saturday afternoon.
Loser.
I know, right? Fucking loser, dude. I would go to that project just to name some of his other projects. He has a project called Wu Chains.
Who doesn't have a Wu Tang Clan and 2 Chainz?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
He has one called More Ninth.
Ninth Wonder. Okay, more.
It's exactly like think about how it sounds. More Ninth. What album does it sound like? More Ninth.
More Nights? Future?
More Life.
Oh, and Drake?
Yeah, Drake and Ninth, which I'm like, huh?
Yeah, I gotta listen to
Not
that
to say huh, but...
No, I gotta listen to that.
That was one of the first ones I listened to. This one's obvious. He has one called The Damn Chronic.
You're Dr. Drake.
Great title names, though, right?
It is. I like it.
Another one he has called Chance the Dropout.
Kanye West and Chance the Rapper.
Yeah, so, you know, again, that's like... I fuck with it.
I might listen to that
It's Kanye clever. Word. It's like, it's not just... Pick a acapella and pick an instrumental and change the BPMs. It's actually like produce this shit.
Yeah,
it makes sense. No different than Lloyd Banks saying, "I'm so used to sending my verses to people."
Yeah,
really J. Cole sent the verse. You know, Eep sent the verse.
He put a beat. Yeah,
he
put a beat.
You know what I'm saying?
Mastered it.
So I really appreciate that from DJ Critical Hype.
Shout out.
Smino's mixtape. She Already Decided. I've bumped that more than once, so that's in my rotation as well. Otherwise, my rotation on Spotify was very long this week again. It's been very intentional for me to go and deep dive into albums. So I'm going to start with the oldest leading to the newest, time-wise in terms of days of the week. I started with Wale the Gifted.
Mm.
And I don't even know why I went to the Gifted. Because normally I go to Ambition
is
or More About Nothing or Mixtape About Nothing or whatever. But I went to the Gifted and I'm like, this shit is fucking fire. I'm not, and it's not me forgetting, it's just me not remembering.
Yeah, it's just one of those, like, you listen to, like, damn, I forgot how fire this was.
Speaking of Saturday afternoons, if you want the perfect playlist for that, T-Pain versus Lil Jon. Remember I was bumping that on Division?
Yes, you were. You were bumping that on Division.
It's like, we're like, man, this is like grade 9 all over again.
Every song was so old.
I couldn't, like, it's crazy how much that defines our fucking childhood. I bumped Bears Like This by Spillage Village. Spillage Village. I bumped the Why Worry single by Isaiah Rashad. Mm. Then I bumped The Sun's Tirade by Isaiah Rashad. Obviously, got to go back to the album. I bumped the Versus battle between Babyface and Timbaland. And what I really like about it is this time Spotify actually got on it officially. Because Tidal been making these. Like, as soon as the battle's done, 1201, Tidal has a playlist.
Tidal's the one making it?
Them.
Or someone is making it?
No, Tidal.
Oh, shit.
Like, they're on it because they're really about the music, right? Or at least that's their perception of brand.
That's what the short is.
Let me not act like I'm falling for brands. But yeah, I bumped that, and that was an official one by Spotify, so I'm happy to know that it's in order and whatnot. Wale, Wow That's Crazy. Bumped that one. That was enjoyable. I bumped the Black Album by Jay-Z. I bumped the Blueprint by Jay-Z. I just went down a path of Lupe Fiasco, man. I bumped the Cool by Lupe Fiasco. I bumped Food and Liquor.
Food and Liquor one.
And then I always talk about, because Lupe is my third favorite rapper of all time.
You said that.
And that's official now, like third.
Official.
I always talk about Food and Liquor and the Cool. Like, I'll put that duo up against any duo.
Jeez.
Any. Like, give me Good Kid and I'll put up.
And damn. Jeez.
I don't care. I'll put up Lupe against anyone with those two, right? Lupe's favorite album of his is Tetsuo and Youth.
Mm-hmm.
So I bumped that's the one with Mural on it, obviously, for those that are unaware. And I'm like, I think I get why these albums are better. Or, sorry, I get why this album is better than the
other. So you like that one?
No. I mean, I love the album, but it's not better.
It's not better.
It's not better. No, don't do that. Don't do that. I mean, nostalgia factor, of course, is a huge role, but
huge.
Don't do that. Staying on the playlist stuff, I do bump a lot more playlists nowadays. I bumped the Jonte Austin vs. Neo playlist. Oh, okay. I felt like listening to some 2000s R&B. Why not? I bumped, let's see here, the T-Pain single, which we didn't even announce, but that was T-Pain featuring Chris Brown.
Oh, yeah, that sounds hard,
Wake Up
too.
Dead.
I like it.
Hard.
I bumped it like hard. A few times back to back to back.
Hard, for sure. I bumped the Smoke Dizza project. That one's called Worldwide Smoke Session. It came out last week. Again, along that realm of just reliable. This is super reliable hip-hop. Of course, I'm going to go back and bump that Division. You know I'm going to go to that Division. Amuse and Her Feelings. That's a phenomenal project. Otherwise, I bumped The Bluest Note several times by Sky Zoo. In terms of the playlist that I'm listening to the most, that RZA Premier.
RZA against DJ Premier.
Playlist. And I'm gonna play that little one part that I keep talking about. So like I said, the best transition is The Enemy going into Run. Mm-hmm. The Enemy by Big L, Run by Ghostface. Fuck who did I offend? Rappers, sit back, I'm about to. If you don't know The Enemy by now, come on now. So as the song is ending,
suddenly started coming at you, armed to the teeth, and ready to kill you.
The next song comes in as such. This has a good. It almost felt like a continuation of the beat, which is very interesting because those songs are very different from one another. But yeah, no, in terms of my rotation, again, a lot of playlists, a lot of, let's call it non-DSP stuff, and just a lot of fucking music in general. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, look, on Spotify, they have five of the verses. Six is actually.
Yeah, so they definitely went John, back and cleaned
Scott
up.
Scott Storch, Manny Fresh, Neo, Jonte Austin.
I should get that Scott Storch RZA, one.
DJ Premier.
Swizz, I love those Manny
Timba,
Fresh records,
and
man.
Baby Fresh, Teddy Riley.
Okay. Baby so. Fresh. That's funny. But you meant Baby Face. It's okay. You're reading fast, and we're exhausted because we're 100 minutes in at this point. I don't know if you noticed that, but I also lose it at this point. Yeah. So let's obviously finish off the show because it's very responsible for us to have a post-potpourri.
So end it by.
Yeah, I mean, got to go. So what are you talking about? What did I put on here?
You put GSW X Last Dance.
Golden State Warriors said we are not filming our shit.
Their loss.
They fucked up.
I don't know why you don't want to film your shit.
That was dumb.
I don't know why you don't want to film it.
That was real dumb because... if I'm not mistaken.
I want my chips with the dip. That's all I know.
Oh, maybe that's why they don't want to film.
I think the Raptors filmed theirs. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Raptors film everything.
And then,
you feel me? I'm feeling good, baby.
Correct me if I'm wrong. That was from a film, right? That was from something that was filmed when we won the title?
No, no. That,
know what I'm saying?
That was an interview.
Oh, my God. This guy can't just go with the moment, dog.
Yes, it was.
This guy's being correct and shit. That was stupid. That's stupid of them.
Though. I don't know why they were done.
That was real stupid.
They're big mad. I think they're big mad after this season.
Yeah, they're big mad. They're big mad. Speaking of big mad, Draymond.
Man, that guy's talking so much shit. It's pissing me off. That guy's the person that talks so much shit in the offseason.
Draymond speaks about Charles Barkley.
Yes. See what you have about the Raptors?
Listen, would Golden State have won if Kyrie K. Love wasn't injured? That's all I'm saying.
I'm with you. I agree with you.
So Draymond obviously talks his shit about Charles Barkley. He said, yeah, that guy scored a couple points or whatever, but I had a bigger impact on the game. And this is me creating the headline because that's some of what he said, right?
Yeah.
He's obviously referring to or alluding to winning, whereas Charles Barkley does not have a ring.
Yep.
But, I mean,
yeah.
I saw somebody tweet. Let me just give you the perfect comparison, bro. Somebody tweeted, you ain't never see Steve Kerr talk that shit about John Stockton. You ain't never seen that. Kerr got the ring. Stockton doesn't.
Mm.
Kerr was a pivotal part of that team.
Stockton was too.
No, so is Stockton. But my point is this. Draymond's a pivotal part of the team.
Mm.
Kerr was a pivotal part of the team.
Yes.
You're never seeing Kerr talk to John Stockton like that.
He's not.
Because Stockton is an all-time great at his position.
And that is what
Barkley is an all-time great at his position.
Mm-hmm.
That's all that needs to be
said. Oh, I agree with you. Oh, it's not that I agree with you. Yes.
Draymond
needs to respect the past.
Toronto's getting in on the protests regarding staying inside.
Oh. So have you seen a backstory about these protests?
They're silent. They're peaceful protests. Sorry, not silent.
No, do you know who created it?
Well,
we don't know who, but all the websites were
anonymous?
Registered.
Anonymous? I don't know.
All the websites were registered around the same time, literally minutes between each other.
Okay.
All the Facebook events were signed up around the same time. They all had the same description, just locations different. So everyone, there's always conspiracy theories.
Of course.
That say government are doing that for whatever reasons, conspiracy theories.
Is that what they're saying?
Yeah, but I just think it's just kind of fishy that all of this, all the websites are all built by the same IP address.
100%.
The same, created within the same time. Just a little fishy.
100%.
Keep your third eye open.
Add a little bit of context to that. So in Toronto, they are starting to do these anti-lockdown protests in a quote-unquote peaceful fashion.
Are they 6 feet apart? Why they protest?
If you look at the... Actually, they are a little bit spaced out. I'm not going to lie.
They're like, yo, we don't want to stay inside, but we also don't want to get sick.
Yeah. I'm trying to see if you see anyone wearing masks. I don't even want to watch.
They are. Either, I think they are wearing masks.
Which is super counterintuitive. But I guess, someone... I'm not mad at this, first of all. I'm not mad at this. People protesting because let natural selection do its thing.
You're right.
Right?
Yes.
Why are we fighting you to save your life?
You know what? Go die.
By all means.
Be cool. We need. What's it eventually for ourselves?
It don't make no sense. Somebody in the Toronto Twitter universe, obviously I don't want to mention any names just in case. I don't know. But they tweeted the following, and this really put things in perspective for me. They said, Caucasians cannot handle being told what to do. We're all being told to stay inside due to a pandemic, and now they are protesting and jeopardizing their people / their country's health because they feel oppressed for once in their life. And I was like,
thank you.
Oh, you potted now. That's what I said to her. But let me give her a...
Well, it's like that.
I didn't mean to do that, but...
It's like that whole Karen thing that's going on because they don't even call it Karens.
Yeah, apparently Karen's offensive. Because
it's worse than the N-word.
Because nigger isn't.
It's worse than the N-word because sexism has been around longer than slavery.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Karen. I already have nothing.
Yeah, I think that's it for me, man. I'm not going
to
lie to you.
You better call it a day.
This is probably going to be the longest episode we ever have in 2020.
Yeah,
honestly. I promise you that.
Honestly, blame music. Honestly, blame the music.
Yo, so much music came out. Music came out, man. But if we are gonna go, then we can't go unless you cue the music. Because with that being said, that will take us to the end, the unfortunate end of another episode of True North Views Podcast. It's been episode 103, the longest episode ever. Actually, no, what was our longest episode? Didn't we touch 2 hours once?
We've touched 220. I'm pretty sure we've touched 240.
Well, when we thought we were Joe Budden podcast.
Yeah, we're on Joe Budden's
level. Wow.
We thought we were on Joe Budden's level.
But listen, we proved that we can do 2.5 hours of content.
You can.
That's all I'm going to really say. Give it to us. It's on our resume. Correct me if I'm wrong.
We will do it to you guys again. But
you know what I'm saying?
If you want, I'm sure we can show you.
We're not going to make this one that long. But with all the conversations that we've had, we ask that you please continue that conversation by telling a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend
to tell a friend.
A friend. Please. Now, as usual, I go by the name of Harris.
And y'all know me. I'm the skirt master, Mr. Triple Double himself. No assist. Stealing 70 mil from the TTC. It's 2020. Jeez. And I'm an NBA champion. You can call me just Shola.
Cheese, 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 cheese.
Cheese.
Please, we got 2 rules under this pandemic. So please tell them the 2 rules.
First rule, please stay safe.
Stay safe.
And second rule, please watch out for the wastemans.
Watch out for the motherfucking wastemans. Now it's the True North Views Podcast, episode 103. Peace.